this video, we will implement traveling salesman problem in Python. So here you can see this is the final output. We have the optimal route and minimum distance. As you can see here, we have total 5 cities, and you can see the distance between each city. And in the green dotted line, you can see here, this is the optimal route, that is from A to B, then B to D, then D to C, C to E, then back to A. Done. Now step by step, we will implement traveling salesman problem in Python. Traveling salesman problem we already discussed in this video, where we applied ant colony optimization algorithm to solve traveling salesman problem. You can check the link given below in the description box. Right now you can see here we have total 5 cities, and you can see the distance is given between each city. And here you can see this is the distance dictionary. It contains all the distances like between A to B, that is 10, you can see here, A to C, 15, A to D, 20, then A to E, that is 25, like that, from B, from C, from D, and all. So first they will create this distance dictionary in Python. So first they will import here important libraries, then from we're using this message box to display the final output, that is optimal route and the minimum distance. So first we will create here distance. So here you can see I have this graph here on this paper that I'm using here to create the distance dictionary. You can see here on the screen. So here we have a variable distance that will hold all the values. So first we have from A to B, that is 10. Next from A to C, that is 15. Next A to D, that is 20. Next A to E, that is 25. Now we have from B to C, that is 35. Next B to D, that is 30. Next B to E, that is 45. Next C to D, C to D, that is 12. Next C to E, that is 18. The last one we have from D to E, that is 50. So we created here the distance dictionary for all the cities from A to B, B to C, C to D, and then D to E. Now we will update this distance dictionary. For example, you can see here we have distance from A to B is 10. Like that, distance from B to A is also 10. Like that, we will do for all the cities. E to D is 50, then D to E is also 50. So you can see here the updated distance dictionary. A to B is 10, then B to A is also 10, AC is 15, CA is also 15, it is 50, then DE, you can see here, DE is also 50. So now we will update this distance dictionary. Next we will update distance dictionary. Now we will update this distance dictionary. We have distance dot update, that is city 2 to city 1, distance for, that is the distance for city 1 to city 2, and we will access the distance from the original distance dictionary. So here you can see we have the original distance dictionary and the updated distance dictionary. So here in the reverse order, we will calculate the distance for each city and we will access the distance from the original distance dictionary. Now you can see here we have different possible routes from A, from B, from C, from D and from E. As we have total, so as you can see here we have total 5 cities, it means we have total 120 possible routes. So next we will calculate the total distance for each route that start from A, B, C and D. So here we will calculate the distance for each route from A, from B. Now you can see here we have different routes. Next we will calculate the distance for each route. So next we will calculate total distance. So here we will define a function that is calculate total distance. And we have one input parameter that is route. So for each route we will calculate the total distance. And initially total distance is 0 and we will calculate this for I in range length of root minus 1. And here total distance is calculated as plus, we will access the distance dictionary and here we have root I to root I plus 1. And now we will add the distance from the last city to the start city, that is in the distance dictionary we have root minus 1 to root I 1 to root 0. So here we added the distance from the last city to the starting city. Then in the end we will return here total distance. Now let's see how it is working. So here you can see we have total 5 cities. Initially distance is 0 and value for I we have 1, 2, 3. Now you can see we have 5 cities. You can see the index for 5 cities 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Next, we will calculate the total distance. Initially value for I is 0. So here put the value for I. Here we have root 0 and root 0 we have A and 0 plus 1 is 1 and at 1 we have 1. So here we have distance between A to B and distance between A to B we have 10. So total distance right now we have 10. Next value for I we have now 1. Now put the value for I here 1 and 1. So it is at 1 we have B, at 2 it is C. The distance between B to C is 35 and in the previous step we calculated total distance 10. Now we will add this distance here. So we have 10 plus 35, that is 45. Now value for I we have 2, put the value for I here, and we got at 2 it is C, at 3 it is D. Distance between C to D we have 12, add this here and we got 45 plus 12, 57. Now value for I we have 3, put the value here and we got root 3, that is D, and at 4 we have E. Distance between D to E is 50 and we got 57 plus 50, 107. In the last we will add the distance from last city back to the start city. So here we have from E to A, that is 25, so add here the distance and we got 132. So you can see here for the first route, that is A, B, C, D, E, we calculated the distance, that is 132. So like that we will calculate the distance for each route, and then in the end they will display the shortest route having minimum distance, that is right now 95, and route is ABC and the route is ABDCE. Now we will define the main function that will calculate the minimum distance and optimal route, and we have here one parameter, that is cities. So we have the example here. So here we have cities, that is A, B, C, D, and E. So here you can see inside this function we have one input parameter, that is cities. So minimum distance initially we have the positive infinity. And optimal route is empty. Now we will find out the all possible routes using this tool. So here we have for route in, permutations we will perform here for all the cities. We have total 5 cities, so here we have 120 possible routes. Now we will call this function here that we are using to calculate the total distance. We have total distance is equal to calculate total distance, and we have here for the routes. So calculate total distance for the routes. We'll check if total distance is less than minimum distance. If this condition is true, then we will consider the minimum distance as the total distance, and optimal route would be that route, would be that route contain the minimum distance. The end it will return optimal route and minimum distance. Here we will call all the functions to find out the optimal route and minimum distance. So optimal route and minimum distance is calculated by this function. So here we have optimal route and minimum distance, that is calculated by this function. Now using message box we will display optimal route and minimum distance message. So here we have message optimal route. We'll use here message box to show info. Here we have this variable message. And we can also print the values. Now run the code, and you can see we find out the, and you can see here right now we find out the optimal route, that is 125 unit. We have one error, that is print. Here we have print. Again run. So optimal route we have A, E, C, D, B. There is 125 unit. So optimal route we obtained here from A, E, C, D and V. We can display all the routes and its values here using this print distance for the route, total distance for the route, that is in the units. Run. Now you can see here we have all possible routes and their values, and among all you can see here we have minimum, that is A, E, C, D, B, this one. So this is the optimal route for this problem. So we can write the code for the graph and then display the optimal route, that is find out having the minimum distance. That's all about this video. If you have any questions, you can comment below, and thanks for watching this video.